Hello, my dear baby, and welcome back. So, last time we were rotating in squad 2 and I sent them on this mission. Just a standard elimination mission. And it will defend our territory. And then I will not do not know what we will do. So let's start. Okay, it might be still be light, but we have our fancy helmet, hopefully it actually works in night, I don't know. I have my doubts. Okay, let's go. Oh, and it's a lowland terrain, I didn't
your
really
order,
check
sir.
It. But that's okay, we have good equipment for it. Oh, windmills. Okay,
More orders!
Yes, sir.
More orders!
More orders!
Ready, sir.
Ready, sir.
Ready, sir.
Ready, sir. Okay, so let's spread out a little bit.
More orders!
Yes, sir.
More order.
What is it?
What is it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
There's one.
Okay, a plankton. It should be easy to dispatch. Like, start firing, you already
now
have
what?
52% chance.
Your order, sir. He's out of range now.
Okay.
What is it?
Spread out a little bit and start firing.
Yes, sir.
Oh wow, that was the Remington.
Waiting further orders.
Now oh. What?
Your order, sir.
Wow,
he can't
he's out
move
of
now.
The way.
Good.
Now what?
Do we want to change magazine? Well, we have a plenty of extra magazines. So why not? We have more magazines than maybe enemies.
Ready, sir.
Okay, continue.
Here they come.
What is it?
Here, more ammo. Beat. A Colt, it looks like.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
What is
your order, sir?
Wow, we can start firing.
Now what?
What now, sir?
Wow! Critical hit! Wow!
I made it!
It had like 20% chance and we hit it twice. Critically, wow. I love the Remington already. I mean, it's the, you know, first sniper rifle, so probably the weakest, but it already shows just how superior it is. Okay,
ready, sir.
You still continue walk.
More
that direction,
orders.
You continue walk.
Ready, sir.
No, you should be going the middle.
More orders!
And you keep to the border.
Here they come!
Oh, wow. Plankton. Probably you are behind the hill, yes, so that's why you cannot fire over
it. More orders!
And the same might be
yes,
true
sir.
For you too, guys. So run over
now
here.
Now what?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now we can.
What now, sir?
Back off. Back off.
Your orders, sir.
Now what?
Ready, sir.
What is it?
Okay.
Your order, sir.
Okay, start firing.
What is it?
Spread out.
Your order, sir.
You could ambush it, now that the others are firing at it. Okay, nice.
What is it?
Okay, it's firing, I think, on Zinatul, looked like, so run and run this
no
direction.
Way to get there!
This direction, no way to get there, my baby told me that you cannot understand what he says, so I will try to translate.
Ready, sir.
Yeah, that's... Come There's on. One! Oh wow, that's a flopper. And once again, unfortunately, I instinctively pressed space. The game stopped the game, but I pressed space and that started the game. But okay, so there we can fire at the plankton.
Now what?
Yes, okay, sir.
You don't need to fire anymore.
Your order, sir.
What is it?
What it is, and he previously said, now what? But yeah, just keep running. And
Shavat
will finish it, or probably the flop, the poor flopper too, with the RPG. Oh, what? Oh, I didn't know Shavat to kneel down, so maybe the RPG can only be fired from a kneel down position.
I'm in trouble!
Yeah. Fire! Wow. Okay,
ready,
that's
sir.
Firing. Still at...
What
Zinatur.
Is it?
Okay. Wow, yeah. So that's the RPG.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I reload it with the back from the backpack. And... So you don't have healing. Zinatur is far away. And you are the better healer anyway.
Your orders!
So, Brian, run here.
What is it?
Do not walk back here. Run back here. Okay.
Awaiting further orders.
You can stand up.
Awaiting further orders.
Yeah, you can also run towards
Ready,
Brian
sir.
Too. Okay, stop,
ready, sir.
Stop.
Your order, sir.
Now what?
Your order, sir.
Ready, sir.
Okay, let's get the med pack. Heal Serat.
More orders.
There's one.
Okay, there is some more ammo with a rifle.
What is it?
Okay, start. Kneel down and start firing. Maybe not. Just kneel down.
What now, sir?
Okay, you finished. Well, heal him again.
Awaiting further orders.
And now, let that get back and this up.
Your orders, sir.
Okay.
I can't see a way.
Oh, by the way, we didn't check. We needed to kill five. Not that it matters, but 1, 2, 3, 4, that's a fifth.
Your orders, sir.
Okay.
What now, sir?
Okay, kneel down and start firing.
Now okay. What?
You start firing too.
Yes, sir.
Oh, we can. We are in range for the more ammo, but I think I will not waste the RPG to it. Maybe walk back here. Zinatur,
no,
don't
what?
Fire, you are wasting the ammo.
That's it!
Okay, that was a great hit.
Yes, sir.
Dead.
Okay. He's out of commission.
We got the 5 kill, but I will press continue for 2 reasons. To save and to search the rest of the
Ready,
area.
Ready, sir.
And you should reload using ammo from the backpack.
What is it?
Not all. Run
no
right
way
there.
To get there.
Ready, sir.
Shravat cannot run. That's what I detecting.
Awaiting further orders.
Yeah. Aha, so having a launcher weapon, a heavy weapon, makes the user unable to run. Seems like. I cannot select him to run. I should rewatch the footage. Because by default, when the mission starts, everyone is running. So, probably he was already on walking. Okay, so that's interesting, so stay in the middle.
What now, sir?
Okay, you reloaded. Yeah, you should run in the middle too. And fast speed.
More orders!
Your orders, sir. I can't see a way.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so we are basically just combing through the terrain here.
Here they come!
More. Oh, a poor flopper.
Your orders, sir.
Zinato, you have, yeah, you have a Glock. No, shut up, you run here.
I made it!
You are ready, I'm ready, that's what he said.
Your orders, sir.
Ready, sir.
Oh, I can try that out. So put this to the ground, put this to the hand.
What now, sir?
And now he can run. So yeah. Anyway, I got the pistol because I'm gonna finish off this poor flopper.
He's out of commission.
Yeah. And so yeah.
Awaiting further orders.
So yeah, he's on run, and if I move this to his hand, it will become walk.
Awaiting further orders.
Yeah. Not when I put it, but when I give a move order, then it becomes to walk. Okay.
What now, sir?
So yeah, I think that was the last enemy. Okay, end the mission. Oh no, I didn't save. Crap. Crap, that's not good. Well, let's see what will happen. One soldier's wounded, zero have to be sick bail, killer one enemy is five, enemies incapacitated, none of them reach new level, continue. Okay, wow, that was a very fast loading screen. Oh wow. It loaded super fast. Okay. So I'm thankfully didn't cross because I forgot to save the mission. Okay, so that was an easy mission. I have plenty of ammunition left. So I don't need to return to the base. And there is no level ups too, so there is no trainings available too. So I have no reason to return to base. So the next question is, what do I only have two missions right now? Oh, but you see, we finished this mission, which was only a self-defense mission because we already have this area under control, 100% presence. But because these two territories are adjacent to this one where we just did this mission, and so this increased our presence. So now we can see the border regions of these the borders of these two provinces too. Okay. Yeah, and we can even see that there is a difference in the color of them. This is the most transparent, I think, and this is less transparent. I think this might be less transparent than that, or I think that might be the same transparency. But I think that's pretty clear over here, that this province is more transparent than that, which means that we have less hold of it than this. Okay. So yeah, where to go? I could go to that mission in Newfoundland, or I could go to this self-defense mission, capture a Transgenant. Yeah, and this is the older mission, but I am not gonna do it. Well, most, the human side, the Tonsgren that we can pick up are all captured, so I think only the Chomper. Maybe we can see here, maybe? What is that we didn't capture yet? Yeah, the Chomper we didn't capture. And Spore Blower either. Spore Blower we might be able to pick up, the Chomper we cannot pick up, it's too big. So the only reason to capture it is to kill every enemy except that, well, not, you know, to clear the area, and then if it's not dead. But yes, we saw we need to be very careful, because so far we killed him every time, so we need to lower each HP and then switch into a pistol maybe, so that we can deal just a little bit more damage. But yeah, this means that since this is a capture Tonsgren mission, it, you know, should be a mission to capture a Chomper, or it will have a new enemy. Because everyone else, and Chomper or a Spore Blower. So go over there or go over here, the two is basically the same distance. Well, let's go do this. This is the older mission and the self-defense mission. Let's see. Okay, let's do it. And how is the research is going? 75%. 3 hours and we will finish with this. Okay. But it will be a mission in the darkness. Commander, our scientists uncover the secrets of twilight and fall. And there it is. So what did our research come up with? From media records and satellite surveillance tapes, we were able to establish that the attacks took place simultaneously all over the globe over the course of several days. The planet was initially attacked using some sort of biological agent, which clouded the skies and then coated the land. As we can see, nothing much survived the incident. Some installations were attacked more conventionally, with weapons from space, but we can't perceive any pattern in the attacks. So yeah, that's all we discovered. Basically, we knew all of this, but this will be, to have this research will be a requirement for later resources, I'm pretty sure. Ah, there! Oh, it's a development. So yeah, we can see here that the Twilight and Fall research is necessary for the Goodwill campaign. So I might wanna change you over into developing engineering base. Or I can, you know, double down on the auto space. So let's see what the preliminary says. Goodwill campaign. Although the human race was greatly reduced by the fall, as it is now called, mankind wasn't entirely destroyed. Among the survivors there were many different groups, some led by would-be dictators, some be would-be savers, others merely given to looting useless goods from the stores. Some are actually good people just trying to survive on what's left out there. We should gather them together, the good and the bad, and try to rally what is left of the world around us. Okay. I think, you know, other than this having, you know, other further things to go on with it, I think this might increase our recruitment rate. I mean, we did have like 3 people very fast, but probably because we have very few people. Yeah. So yeah, I wanna do this, but I have no development facilities available. So either I double down on the research or change it to engineering base. So yeah, what do we want? Well, I mean, the slime troll is the latest and latest enemy and seems like the most dangerous one. So yeah, I could go by order they appeared. Yeah, or I could go by, you know, what was the latest and most dangerous. Yeah, I think I will just go with the order of their appearance. Or, you know, I could go with the flopper if we go from the least threat to the most threat. You know, I think I will go with the flopper. Poor little birds, deprived of their feathers, doomed to just crawling around. Their desperate cries don't make us happy, that's for sure. They seem to be harmless, but who knows? Yeah, let's do that flopper. Okay, 1 day, 2 hours left. Well, currently, but if I change over to do the Goodwill campaign... Nah, I will not. I will just, you know, I will, no, I do not know. I mean, the auto speed will give me information of what do they resist and stuff. So do I wanna change this, or change this back into a an engineering base? No, I wanna do this. I am changing you to engineering. Okay, so currently it says 6 days and 20 hours left. And the research is now 1 day 7 hours. Okay. Okay, let's continue then. Or I maybe should check my clock. Yeah, okay, let's continue. Ooh! We detected a UFO commander, size small, type laboratory. Okay, there it is. Yes, intercept. Okay, and so yeah, now those are intercepting. So yeah, I do not know if I have two military bases, can I send both of them? Or can I just send them one at a time though? That's possible too. But yeah, I will not know now. So there is the laboratory. Ooh! So yeah, you know with the entry that there is two different types of laboratory. Small, and this is the small. So there's probably a big one too. The laboratory. The analysis of the wrecks of this UFO. So yeah, we don't have wrecks yet, but okay. The wrecks of this UFO suggest it's some kind of laboratory. Various scientific, or what we assume to be scientific, instruments were found inside. The laboratory UFO can be either small, very similar to the larger observer, or larger, about the size of a small transporter or planter. So yeah, once again, these are spoilers, but from the game itself. So yeah, there are transporter UFOs or planter UFOs. Side of small transporter or planter, and apparently those two have smaller and larger versions, at least, you know, according to this, though distinct from them, the larger laboratory. Laboratories are poorly armed and protected, and they always fly under the cover of three fighters. Aha, okay, I see. So the observers are not always commonly accompanied, and the one we saw was not. And this one, the small version, and they say that they are always fly under the cover of fighters, and yeah, this one does too. So yeah, but we gotta destroy it. So yeah, I'm sending the fighters. Hopefully they will intercept. Yes, set time to small. Okay, it's actually in getting our way, and this is a Hornet too. Okay, so we have good odds to intercept them. But then we do not know. The odds are against us. It's 4 of them versus 3. Well, yeah, the laboratory itself is poorly armed. But it also have 3 fighters. So yeah, I might just, you know, I might just wanna save before the fight and reload if we lose. I know that would be safe coming. Okay, who will get to their target first? I think we will get to their UFOs first, because they are actually coming our way a little bit. Okay, I wanna save, because really, getting the first UFO mission with the aliens, pretty important. So let's just save your spear. Okay, so the first interception, I think, gonna happen now in this episode. Because yeah, we are getting to them faster than the helicopter to there. Okay, yep. Oh, it moved. Hope it doesn't want to. Oh no. Aha, there was a jerk in the movement and it changed direction. Stop. So there is a mission in Thule. It changed direction. It was moving up and now it's moving south. It might start, but if it was running to run away, then it would be moving this direction, not this direction. Okay, and so there is a new mission available here. In a completely new unknown direction. Thule, I think that's the capital of Greenland and somewhere here. We need to capture a last specimen. Okay. Highland and polar region. Okay. But first I will save. I mean, I don't know if I will reload or not if we fail, but we should not fail. You know, this is the first intercept on the earlier to a wreck we can get, the better. Yep, we are intercepting it. Okay, here we go. So I already told you before what to expect. There will be a small window with the animation. I think there will be a little screen telling us the status, the damage reports. So yeah, it will be, I think it, yeah, I remember to be pretty fast flowing. So it can be over pretty quickly. Especially since we have basically, you know, just standard, fighters. 1980s technology versus, you know, alien fighters and the laboratory. So yeah, I'm very excited. So excited that I almost could, you know, make this a cliffhanger and do the fight in the next episode, but that would be disappointing, right? So I will not do that. Okay, let's do this thing. Wish the fighters good luck, honey. Long live the fighters. Okay, and we intercepted it. Ah yeah, this is the music. Yeah, I think this is the music. Aww. Yeah, it's as fun and upbeat as I remember it. Wow. The memory for, you know, dozens and dozens of fights. Oh, it ends. Why? Okay, it's looping, okay. So yeah, our fighters are going to engage the enemy in air combat. Okay, let's do this. Okay. Yes! Oh no! Yes! Yes! Haha! Victory! Our fight with Herenge is the enemy and won. We lost no aircraft. Yes! Wow, yeah, it is as fast-paced as I remember, and I don't even, you know, I don't even pay attention if there is any button to retreat. But yeah, so in other games there is more micromanagement possible, but not a lot. And this is basically just a little cinematic, but I love it. It's so exciting. The animation and the music together, it's very upbeat. Of course, it will not be upbeat if we lose. But yeah. So yeah, I'm gonna rewatch this fight a couple of times after I finish this recording. Whew. Okay. Carry on. Okay, and so this will it fight to cover known, and this is destroyed too. This will crash down very, very soon. I have to start the time again, and we will have a mission over here to capture the crash site. There it is. A new mission is available near Washington, and if it lands over a body of water, then we don't get that, and that's bad. So we have to try our best to shoot them down over land. Okay, the fighters are on their way home. And there is the new mission. An alien craft has crashed here. Secure it for future investigation by eliminating the enemy presence in the area. Urban UFO crash. Whatever is urban. Okay. Okay. And so yeah, this mission, aside from, you know, good for getting a bunch of alien stuff and the hull, which will enable us to do the advanced UFO detection and the UFO assets, because yeah, right now we will not be able to get into the UFO. We will just grab the, you know, soldier. But in later missions it will be a two-faced mission to first, you know, get into the alien and then clear out the alien, get into the UFO and clear out the UFO. But since we don't have the technology, we cannot get into the UFO. So yeah, and we cannot get internal things like the UFO computers. So first I will need to research this one first. And then later, yeah, if I have computer, then it will help speeding up the advanced UFO detection. But anyhow, this is way more important. Okay, so yeah, first major victory. And we can even see that it's a small little saucer. The mission signal icon. Okay, alright, I will end the episode here. I think we are so close to this mission that now, you know, aborting to here is no point. So I will do this, and then I'm pretty sure I'm gonna go here. Alright. I hope you had fun. I had fun. See you next time. Bye bye.